Hello friends, welcome you all to my channel. Today I am going to show you few key highlights of latest Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9 along with ISO file download from RHEL official website and installation with manual partition. Let's get into the tutorial. Let us now have a glance at some of the key highlights of RHEL 9. What's new in Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9? RHEL 9 offers the following new versions of dynamic programming languages: PHP 8.0, Ruby 3.0, Node.js 16, Perl 5.32, Python 3.9. RHEL 9 offers the following database servers: MySQL 8.0, Redis 6.2, MariaDB 10.5, PostgreSQL 13. RHEL 9 offers the following compilers and development tools: GCC 11.2.1, Rust toolset 1.58.1, Glibc 2.34, Go toolset 1.17.7, binutils 2.35.2, LLVM toolset 13.0.1. RHEL 9 offered the following version of control systems: Git 2.31, subversion 1.14. RHEL 9 offered the following proxy caching server: Squid 5.2, Varnish cache 6.6, Linux kernel version 5.14.0, GNOME version 40, containers building with universal base images. Live kernel patching is now supported via web console. To download RHEL 9 ISO, open Google search in your web browser and type download RHEL 9. Click on the first link to go RHEL official site. These are all ISO of different RHEL versions. Click on the red color download button to download the latest one. Type your Red Hat login ID. If you don't have, then click on registered for a Red Hat account. Fill your details. Red Hat login must be unique. Email ID most important here. First name, last name, company name, job role, password. You can fill as per your choice. I have already created. Click on next. Type password for this account. Click on login. Download has been started automatically. After booting through USB drive, this screen is appear. Select install Red Hat Enterprise Linux 9.0 and hit enter. Select your language and click on continue. This is an installation summary page. We need to specify and check all four sections here, such as localization, software, system, and user setting. I am showing here the setting of localization controls such as keyboard, language support, and time and date are okay as per my selection. In software section, connect to Red Hat. If you are a registered user, then type your username and password or activation key of active subscription. I don't have, so leave it blank and click on done to exit this page. In system section, click on installation destination. First, select your hard drive. Select custom to manual partition. Click on done. These are partition type. Click on the plus sign. Select mount point slash boot. Type here in MB format, megabyte. 2GB disk space, fair enough for this bootloader mount point. Click on add mount point. Click on the plus sign. Now select mount point swap. 4GB disk space is sufficient for this virtual memory mount point. Click on add mount point. Now time to create root partition. Click on the plus sign. Select root sign. In desired capacity, I want to assign all remaining space. That's why I'm not going to type any value here. Click on add mount point. Before click on done, check all changes to sanguine completely. Now click on done. Click on apply changes. Now click on network and host name. This IP address generated by DHCP server. Give a name to your host or system. Click on apply. Okay, name is showing here. To assign IP manually, click on configure tab. Select IPv4 setting. Change method to manual from automatic DHCP. Click on add. Type IP. Netmask or prefix. Gateway. DNS. Click on save. Changes is reflecting. You could offer network switch if changes is not reflecting. Click on done. Now set a root password. Type a password what you want to assign for root. You can lock your root account for security reason or allow root through SSH, but I am not going to check any boxes right now. Click on done. Installation source. No need to change anything. It's already detect your USB drive. Click on done. Software section. We want to install server with GUI, graphical user interface, with no additional software. So no need to change anything. Click on done. KDump. KDump already enabled with automatic setting. Leave it as default. Click on done. Security profile. It also pre-activated with default setting. Leave it as default. Click on done. Click on begin installation. Click on reboot system. System is booting. Click on start setup. Privacy. Click on next. Connect online account. Click on skip. Create a local user. Type a name. Click on next. Set a password. Click on next. click on Start using Red Hat Enterprise Linux. Our RDCL 9 installation has been done successfully. This is our beautiful new fresh RDCL 9 system. Hope you all like this video. Please like, share and subscribe my channel to boost me up to create more knowledgeable videos. Thank you.